Hi, I'm Kerrie Douglas, a professor in engineering education. Welcome to my office hours. Come on in.
Hi, I'm Kathryn.
Nice to meet you, Kathryn. I'm Professor Douglas.
I have always had a very clear path at Purdue. I knew I wanted to come here and I knew I wanted to do chemical engineering. So how did you kind of navigate your own path and how do you guide students on theirs?
First of all, I think that's awesome. You knew what path you wanted to go from the beginning. And I definitely did not have that experience. I think I knew so little about engineering, what engineers do, that earlier in my undergrad days, I wouldn't have ever thought I would become an engineering professor. I think a lot of students, it's great to take time to explore, consider other options, not outside of engineering, but consider options because engineering is so broad, considering what the different disciplines do and thinking about both, what do I like to study? Like, you really like to study chemistry, I think. And then also what context I might want to work in. And so those two components can really help somebody as they're trying to navigate what their career path is gonna be.
I know you went to a Taylor Swift concert.
I did.
So I wanna know, do you have a favorite like era or album or song?
This is a question that gets asked to me a lot.
Okay.
By my 13-year-old daughter, but and her friends. But my favorite album is Reputation.
Okay, that's mine.
And I love it because it was such a change in genre for her. And I liked seeing her channel some of the negative things that had happened to her into something and like really channeling that and something amazing.
How do you feel about your professors in college? So your college experience and then translating that to now.
I didn't really know my professors. And they all seemed sort of very intimidating and almost like not real people. Like I was scared to have any kind of interaction with them. And I look back now that I'm a professor and I think like I'm a person and I have a whole life as we've been talking about. And so I think it's really important for students to know that there's a professor that does care about them. So I try really hard to memorize the students' names, especially even in first year engineering where we have 120 students a class.
In your Celebrating Our Associate Professors talk, you did mention how your daughter kind of humbled you when she said no one thought you were in reference to you being a superwoman. Do your kids, I know you have a few, kind of keep you grounded, keep you humble?
My kids totally keep me humble. Like I think anytime I go somewhere and receive, you know, some kind of award or I get an accolade or whatever, like I definitely have my kids who I don't think they particularly care about any of that. And so, you know, they just want me to be mom. I think all kids give their parents crap.
How is it as your kids get closer and closer to your students' age? Like, do you see each group differently?
One of the things I love about teaching in the first year, I get to see students that very first semester that they're on campus and they're transitioning from being with their parents or their family to being on campus on their own. I love being part of that change time with them. I can remember trying to help be sort of an adult that cares about them while they're here, not just about their academics, but also about their adjustment and how they, you know, are managing this time of transition because it is so big.
How do you kind of navigate the idea that like family first and then a job, but you're also a very successful professor and faculty member here. So how do you balance those two, if at all?
I genuinely love being a parent. Like I wouldn't have four kids if I didn't. And I genuinely love having my family, having my husband. I've made decisions along the way that were for the family, even though maybe career-wise a different choice might have been better. Keeping my values where they need to be, I can still go after the things I really want. There are times when I have to work late. I just have to. I'm doing my best to figure it out. And the other thing is I really am passionate about my work. And I think being a professor really affords me a lot of flexibility. At the end of my life, like what my family says about me is most important. And then next, I would say what my students say about me.
That's a good segue to my next question is, what's one thing students should know about you?
I am really friendly and I like to have fun, but I also have pretty high expectations for learning. One time on the end of class eval, someone said her laid back personality doesn't match her grading style.
Oh no!
But I think it's true. Like, I think you can be both fun, enjoy the time, and also challenge yourself. Take pride in, you know, to take pride in your work and do your best.
Yeah, work hard, play hard, right?
Right.
What brought you to Purdue?
My research is specifically in engineering education, and Purdue was the first PhD in engineering education. As I was trying to navigate what my career was going to be, making an impact in everyday lives was important to me. I didn't want to be a researcher who just did research that went to published papers. It was really important to me that what I did actually supported students' learning and would actually improve the education that engineering students have. Because Purdue is so prestigious in engineering education, it was hard for me to get a job. When I initially were getting sort of my rejection letters, I took it to better understand what they were looking for, how I didn't meet what they wanted, and then made sure that I achieved those things. And so that kind of goes back to the Taylor Swift reputation, right? Mm-hmm. Like, this is my art. And so when things are hard, I dive deeper into it.